So she gets into a ballet school.
In her final audition, slips, breaks her back. Oh my God, will she ever dance again?
Okay, we'd like to make a start for our Dance Academy movie webinar, and we are so pleased to see that we have schools and students from all over Australia online at the moment, in particular students from the Northern Territory and Western Australia, as well as South Australia. So welcome to everyone that has beamed in to our Dance Academy webinar. As the excitement builds for the release of the Dance Academy movie on April 6th, which is only 2 and a bit weeks away, and I'd like to welcome and say how privileged we are to have one of the stars of the Dance Academy movie, Alicia Banit, here.
Hello,
Kat Karamikoff, welcome, Alicia.
Thank you so much.
And also the producer and probably the creative inspiration behind Dance Academy, Joe Werner.
Hello.
Joe, welcome. And welcome to all of our schools that are out there. It's just so fabulous to have you online. And all of the great questions that have been sent in by schools and students. But if you'd like to send in some more, we have people watching on the Facebook stream as well as via Zoom.
Alicia's mum is watching on the Facebook.
Alicia's mum is, hello to Alicia's mum. So if you do have questions you might like to ask Alicia or Joe during the webinar, feel free to send them in via the chat that's in Zoom, or if you're on Facebook, you can put them in the comments because we'd love to have them too. But we have so many great questions already. I think we might start, and we have our first question, Joe, for you. Number one, whereabouts is that one from?
That is from, and I can see them on our screen, Melville Primary School.
Hello, Melville.
Hello.
Hey.
And it's from the Year 5 class.
What inspired you to create this TV show? Does it relate to your real life experiences?
Excellent question. Thank you, Luca. And yes, absolutely it does. Dance Academy for me came about when I was working on the first show that I ever produced was a series called H2O, Just Add Water. Has anyone seen that show?
Put your hands up if you've seen H2O.
It's about mermaids. Actually, the casting director was another young woman my age, Sam Strauss. And we were talking one night and she asked me, what show would you make if you could make any show in the world? And I said that I really wanted to make a show about a girl from the country who got into the top ballet school. And she thought I was joking because she had been working for years on a script about a girl from the country who gets in the top ballet school. And she gave me that script to read and it was amazing. It was the best script I've ever read, and she wasn't a professional writer. She was somebody who used to be a ballet dancer and then went to university and did film school at university and was working in casting. So it was this fantastic marriage of both of our passions. Then we worked on it together, and Sam had done so much work in creating these wonderful characters. And then we worked on that together for a few years to get it to the standard that we thought we could pitch it to a network. And then it all happened. So I definitely relate to the story because I grew up outside of a town of 300 people, a little town called Gunbower, and did ballet since I was 4 years old. I unfortunately wasn't good enough to make it into the top ballet school, but I would have desperately loved to. So for me, Dance Academy is the show that I wish I could have watched when I was in primary school and high school.
So thank you, Luca, for such a great first up question. Our second question is for you, Alicia, number two. Where are we heading for that one?
We are heading to Dunsborough Primary School in Western Australia. It's Year 6, and I think Olivia is asking the question. Hello.
Hi there, guys in Dunsborough. Olivia, are you there? Can you...
Alicia, do you feel that there are any similarities between you and your character, Kat?
I get asked this question a lot. Yes, I do. Especially, when I first read the character brief, I loved Kat, and she's super fun and bubbly, and a lot of my personality is fun and bubbly. And then as the series sort of went on, we could have conversations with the writer and producer, Joe, and the director about, you know, where the character could possibly go and different things that we'd like to bring to our character. And so... I became Kat and Kat became me, and she's extremely similar to who I am. I always say she's a little bit more rebellious than I ever was. She would see it as not bowing down to authority. But also on top of that as well, you know, she's, I've always said this as well, she's a better dancer than I ever was.
Which is funny because you're the dancer.
Yeah.
Kat is. You are Kat.
But I think, yeah, I had to work a lot harder at being a good dancer than Kat had to work. And so I think there's obviously similarities and differences, but Kat is very similar to me. So, thanks, Olivia.
Thank you, Olivia. That was a great question. Our next question is also for you, Alicia, question three. And this one has come from a really interesting place. So where are we heading to for question three?
School of the Year, Yulara, the community at Uluru. Hello. Hey. And we have Caitlin.
On dance camera, you do a lot of physical work, dance. What are some tips you could give to a beginner like me on how to keep fit and healthy?
That's a great question.
Yeah, good question.
Great question.
Yeah. I always say, and I think a lot of people always say, it's all got to do with,
balance.
Nice balance. Mm-hmm. I think when it comes to Dance Academy, we had a really intense boot camp before we started filming, but throughout the years in between filming Dance Academy to stay fit and healthy, obviously I'd keep dancing. And if you're kind of new to, physical activity, you always kind of start slow and then you build up as you get stronger. And then same kind of thing, everything in proportion as well with how you eat. Like, you know, you can have all
you
your
love,
snacks.
Yeah,
and,
you can have some,
yeah.
some pizza and things like that.
Yeah, and all in moderation, I think, is the word I was kind of looking for before. I think, you know, I always find sometimes if I get really sick, then I'm back to, you know, the beginning. If I get a cold or a flu or something, back to the beginning of, you know, your body breaking down and being so tired when you start working up. So you've just got to start slow, especially with exercise and stuff like that. With dancing, if you'd want to start dancing or if you already dance, same kind of thing. Practice makes perfect, and the more you do it, the better you'll get at it. And if it's something that you enjoy, I think whether you're the best dancer in the world or the worst dancer in the world, it's going to be fun. And then, yeah, staying fit and healthy is as long as you're enjoying what you're doing and you're able to, you know, enjoy yourself and don't, you know, I think it's silly to cut out food groups and stuff like that. I always think having a healthy, balanced diet is so much better for you. It's kind of, you know, if you cut out a certain food group, you're at risk at, you know, your body depleting at a really fast rate and it's not safe. So, yeah, I think, you know, and especially with the internet these days too, having ideas of looking a certain way, I think, is bad. I think as long as you feel good and you feel healthy, then you're on the right track for sure. I hope that answers your question, Caitlin.
Thank you, Caitlin. That was a great question. It's great to have one coming from the heart of Australia.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's insane. That's amazing.
Amazing. I wonder if it's hot there today.
Yeah.
Now, for question four, we're heading back to Melville Primary School, and I think it's Noah from Year 5. Have we got Noah there with your question? I'll just repeat that one so everyone can hear it. So Noah's question was, did it feel different to film a movie rather than the TV series?
What do you think, Alicia, for you?
I think there was differences and there was also similarities. Sometimes, I guess, with the TV show, we would pump through scenes maybe a lot faster than we did on the film. On the film, I think we had the ability to spend longer on scenes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that was the big thing for me. For on the TV show, we were shooting one episode every sort of 4 days, and an episode goes for half an hour. So for this movie, which is 90 minutes, we shot for 6 weeks. So it was just the time that we got to shoot. So, for example, on the TV show, we might have a dance sequence, and we would shoot that before morning tea.
Yeah.
Whereas on the movie, we would shoot that for the whole day. That was fantastic, but it was also really hard for the actors.
Yeah.
I know, Dina had a dance that she did for the entire day, and that's really, really tough. Like, we were talking about being fit and healthy. Our cast had to be so fit and healthy going into this, and particularly Xenia, who plays Tara, she's doing a lot of dance. So that was probably the biggest difference for the film, just the amount of time that we had to shoot things. But also, we got to shoot in New York.
Yeah,
that was
on
the
top
big
of that
one.
Too. That was incredible. Yeah. And yeah, I think, you know, we could pretend there was different sort of places. I think we had Ethan in Spain at one point. Over
but we didn't
video
really
link
go
and,
to Spain in
yeah,
the TV show.
Yeah, didn't go to Spain.
But
so,
in the movie, we really go to New York.
Yeah.
And that was amazing. We all went over there and it was really hot and we shot a lot of things. And so we were working really hard, but it was pretty fun.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Oh, it was incredible. I was sort of saying before, walking onto set and we're in Times Square, it's like, is this real? Am I really here filming a movie in New York? So yeah, that was crazy. And I think just the idea that it was going to be on a massive screen was also really daunting. I know obviously with television, it's a lot smaller and this is going to be on a huge screen. So that was kind of nerve-wracking just knowing that as well. But
that's going to be weird to see yourself.
It's going to be so strange.
You look gorgeous on it.
I've seen
the film.
Thank you to Noah for that great question. Our next one, question five, is for Alicia. And we're back to Dunsborough Primary School. Alicia, who's asking the question from Dunsborough for
Max
question five?
Max is asking this question.
Hi there, Max. Fire away.
Hello.
Hey.
What is the hardest part about being a dancer and an actor at the same time?
I think the hardest part, honestly, is the multitasking, trying to talk and dance at the same time. I mean, not maybe
and
the...
breathe and remember your lines.
Yeah, there's so much that comes into dancing and acting at the same time on the set. I remember filming a scene with Jenya, who plays Tara, and we were just at a bar and we were doing a bar exercise, and I remember we had to all do the same arms and foot movements all while we were having a conversation. So we had to remember choreography, we had to remember our lines, we had to remember that there was cameras around us and not to hit anybody, we had to remember to breathe and talk clearly. And also be in the moment and be the characters. It is hard work, and obviously as well, dancing and acting at the same time with the show, it's not like you do just one dance and then it's finished. You do the dance over and over and over again, and they use the camera to get it from different angles. And with the movie especially, it was, all day scenes and that many different angles, and it was, big dance sequences,
yeah.
So... It's not an easy task, but one that, when you watch it back, I'm incredibly proud of as well. So, and it's always been my dream job. So it was never, I've got to do an acting and dancing scene at the same time. It was nothing ever like that. It was just, something that you have to work at. And like I said, so proud of the end result too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Terrific question from Max. So thank you to Max. And I think
we're
staying at Dunsborough Primary School for question six. And this one's for you, Jo. Who are we getting to ask that question?
This is Jess.
Hi.
Joanna, what are you most proud of with the Dance Academy series or movie?
I'm very proud that we got to make three series of Dance Academy, because when we first made the show, there's only ever the promise of one series, and so you only get to make another series if you do the first one really well and if people like it. And so the biggest achievement was to get to the movie as well, but to the third series. There was actually a moment when we were worried that we weren't going to be able to make a third series, and we just finished series two. For those who have seen series two, there's something pretty big happens at the end of series two. We lose one of our favourite characters, and everything's kind of up in the air at the end of series two. So if we hadn't have made series three, it would have finished in this, in this way where nothing is completed,
yeah.
And I just don't think, it wouldn't have been
no
good
answers.
For our fans or for us if that had happened. So I think I'm most proud that we got to make our third series and got to finish off where all of our characters go. And now the movie on top is just, that's just the cherry on top. It's fantastic that we got to then go, we get to go and see the movies.
Yeah.
Right. Thank you so much, Jess. That was another terrific question. And we're staying at Dunsborough for question seven. And I think it's Bo.
What is the most stressful part in making the movie?
What was the most stressful part?
I'm going to let you go first, Alicia.
Okay, I'll go first. The most stressful part, I guess, probably wanting to do it justice. Obviously, there's a huge fan base that have watched the TV series. And I think... because there was a break in between, it was yeah, I was really hoping that we could all come together and do the script justice, because it was so beautiful as well. The script is amazing, and the whole story in general is really beautiful. And I think, yeah, I was just wanting to make it the best that it possibly could be. So that, I guess, that was quite stressful. You know, I could say something, I guess, like, you know, the minimal sleep or something like that. But that kind of, yeah, it doesn't bother me compared to wanting this to be so amazing for you guys. So, yeah.
And probably the most stressful thing to me is that moment when you're not sure whether we're going to raise all the money to make it, and so whether it's all possible, because so often it all hinges on this one decision. And I was talking about before about that moment I wasn't sure whether we could make the third series. I was in a meeting, and somebody said, you know, we're not going to. You're not going to be able to make the third series of Dance Academy. It's not going to happen. And I just remember that moment of, you know, I wanted to burst into tears, and I looked away, and I took a big deep breath, and I was there with the fabulous Bernadette from the Australian Children's Television Foundation, and we sort of both, you know, took a big deep breath, and then we just thought, right, how are we going to make this happen? And anyway, the rest is history, and we did get to make it, but I'd say that was the single most stressful time. Yeah.
Imagine. Thank you so much for that question.
Thanks,
too.
Bob.
Thank you.
Now, I think we're heading for question 8 back to Caitlin, the School of the Air. I think this one's for you, Jo.
Hi, Caitlin.
Hi.
Going for a TV series
whose screenplay must be huge. From a producer's point of view, what is such a big transition like?
Great question.
No, that is a great question. So Sam Strauss, who was the creator and writer of the series, she wrote a lot of the series. We had other writers on board as well. But Sam and I started talking about making a movie. You know, we talked about it really early on, but, you know, we weren't sure whether we'd be really able to. But when we got the third series up, then we started to talk about it really seriously, that we'd like to do it. And when we got to the end of scripting the third season, we were in such a great place with all of our characters. We were so happy with how it finished that it actually took us a while and a few false starts to come up with a story that we really thought deserved to be made into a film. We tried a few wacky sort of ideas of things, but then when we settled on the story that we do have for the film, we realised it needed to be big. It needed to be a big hero's journey, because for a TV show, even though there's lots of episodes, each episode is only 22 minutes, and you usually have three different storylines. So you might have the A story might be for Kat, and there might be a second story that features Christian, and the third story might be Tara or something like that. And they're all small stories, but for a 90-minute movie, we needed to sustain a movie character arc, and so that was a big step and a big thing to take on board. And Sam, it's her first film that has been made. She's written other scripts, but this is the first one that's been made. So she's done an amazing job with it, and yeah, it was a big. We knew it had to deliver to the fan base, so it was a big challenge. But I have seen the film now probably about 50 times during the editing. Alicia has never seen it, so she's seeing it for the first time this Saturday night at our cast and crew screening. And I have to just say, it's my favourite movie. The best movie I've ever seen.
All time!
I absolutely love it, and yeah, I really can't wait for everyone to see it.
I think we all want to see it now.
Yeah. I'm so excited. I'm nervous. I'm excited.
Thank you, Caitlin, again, for your second terrific question. Question 9, Alicia, is for you, and I think we're heading back to Melville Primary School. Who's asking that one?
Jack is asking question 9.
How does it feel to be an actor? Are you stopped in the street by fans?
Yes, good question. I absolutely love being an actor, and one of my favourite parts about it is being stopped by fans. It's really, really amazing to see that people actually watch the show and enjoy the show, I guess. And I've said before, one of the main things that I want to achieve as an actor is to make somebody feel something when they're watching my work. And so I've had lots of people come up to me and say things like, you know, your storyline helped me get through this time in my life, and you inspired me to dance, or you inspired me to go back to dancing, and stuff like that. So that I again, I've always said it. It's been one of my favourite parts of being an actor is being able to meet the people that, you know, I could hopefully inspire and change a part of their lives somehow. So it's pretty amazing. It's pretty incredible being an actor, and it's definitely a dream job. And I'm very, very lucky to be in this industry. So,
but there's also the challenges too. Like I'm sure that you've been for auditions before Dance Academy that you didn't necessarily get the job. So,
oh yeah, I've done thousands and thousands of auditions. I've been acting since I was 5 or 6 years old. So, yeah, it's a tricky industry to get into and be a part of. And there is a lot of rejection, but I stuck to it, and yeah, it's hard work, I guess. Another part of it is definitely hard work, and you've got to do as much, you know, I've done as many classes as I possibly could, and still do classes. You can never stop learning, I guess, when it comes to anything, and with acting too, because it's human, and it's you know, you're playing a real person, I guess, you're creating a real person, so... there's a lot of work that goes into acting, and I think the rewards of it, seeing the fans and stuff like that, is indescribable.
Thank you, Jack. That was a great question. Our next one is from a school that I don't think are online, which is Rose Park Primary School. And so, no, they are. We do have Rose Park Primary
Fantastic.
School in South Australia. And we
Hi.
Have a question
hey.
From Rose Park. So I don't know if anyone there wants to ask Alicia the question about her favourite dance style.
My favorite dance style,
I'd probably have to say ballet. When I was younger, I wanted to be a prima ballerina, and I absolutely love ballet. But I love tap, and I love jazz, and I love contemporary. And I used to do acrobatics as well. I think I love all of it, and it's kind of hard to pick a favorite because they're all so different, but I think it all comes down to, you know, when you move your body in a certain way, it can make you feel something really great.
Do you have a signature move?
A signature move. I actually, my favorite sort of stuff is pirouettes. So that's turns. I was great. Especially when I was younger, while we were filming Dance Academy, pirouette, I was like, I could nail them. That was so good. And there was so much fun, like just to feel spinning. It's really amazing. So I think, yeah, I love doing pirouettes and fouettés. I think actually in my audition for Dance Academy, I did some fouettés when they had do your own sort of special move.
Stuff.
And I was...
I think every character had sort of their move. So
yeah.
Jordan has backflip.
Oh yeah.
Dean, who plays Abigail, has a leg.
Yeah,
everyone sort of had their trick.
I definitely pirouettes are my favourite. Feels fun.
Thank you
Thank
to
you
Rose
so
Park
much.
Primary School in South Australia. That was a great question. We have another one for you, Alicia. Question 11. And this one we're heading into Western Australia, and it's Grace, who's a distance education student. So Grace, if you're there.
Hey Grace.
Hi Grace. Would you like to ask Alicia a question? Now I think you had a couple of questions. One of them was, what do you expect or want from a dance partner?
What do I expect or want from a dance partner? I guess it depends sort of who you're dancing with. I guess if it's a pas de deux partner and it's a male, you want... you want strength and also support as you're dancing, because most of the time, if it's a male-female kind of pas de deux, then it's going to be the female's most likely going to be on point shoes, and so the pas de deux partner will be holding her up and making sure that she doesn't fall on the ground. And then there has to be obviously a whole lot of trust with your pas de deux partner as well, if you're going to end up doing lifts and crazy tricks like that. So I think trust and communication, especially during the choreographing time, is extremely important. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
I hope that answers that.
Absolutely. Thanks, Grace. That was a great question. The question 12, this one's for you, Jo. Where are we heading to for that?
We are going to Menzies Community School in WA.
Far away.
Yes. I want to know how long it takes to kind of create kind of a 10-second scene in the movie. So, like, how much filming time, that type of thing, preparation goes into that, just 10 seconds.
So this is probably a big difference between shooting a TV series and shooting a film. So I'll use the example of a 1 minute scene, which is a dance scene. In the series, we would have shot that maybe in 2 hours, but in the film, we shot it in 10 hours. So we would shoot that for the entire day is a 10-hour day, and so that's probably illustrates the biggest difference between TV and film. And then it's not only the time on set that takes. So in the film, our 1 minute dance sequence took 10 hours. It took weeks of preparation to get there. It's very, very labor intensive. And we would have worked, we would have had so many meetings. We probably would have done, just solely on that dance alone, probably 6 full days. So that's 60 hours and then 10 hours to shoot it. And then probably another, 40 hours to edit it. So it takes a long time. And then you've just got to really hope that it's a good 1 minute after all that work.
You'd definitely be hoping that was the case. Yeah. Thank you to Menzies Community School. That was a great question. Our next question is for both of you, and it sort of touches on, you've already mentioned New York, the fact that you were filming in New York. This one's from Dunsborough Primary School again. I think it's from Freya. Freya, are you there from Dunsborough Primary School? No, she's not. Okay, in that case, I'll ask this one for Freya. It's to both of you. Had you been to New York before? If not, was it everything you thought it would be? How much of the movie was shot in New York?
Have you been to New York before?
No, I've never been to New York before. That was the first time I went to New York with you guys. Yeah.
Was it everything you thought?
It was. I've had a lot of friends and family who have gone to New York, and they just said it's going to be your favourite city in the entire world. And it is. It's so beautiful, and it's quite. It makes you feel different things. Obviously, being a big city, it was really kind of, it was hectic, and there was a lot of people all the time, and beeping and cars and everything, and it's kind of quite frantic. And then I remember walking into Central Park and just having this relaxed breath, and I was like, wow, like the whole kind of feeling of it. And I went to some of the museums, and it was just incredible. It was so amazing. And then obviously filming over there and getting to film in these locations that are all, quite the touristy ones, like Times Square, Central Park. We were at the front of, what's the hotel we're at the front of again?
The Waldorf.
It was just incredible. The whole city is amazing, and the fact that I got to see it while I was doing my dream job was awesome. And yeah, I think all of us can sort of say the fact that we got to New York and got to film over there is a massive achievement.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah. I've been to New York before, but for work. So the first time I went to New York was after we'd made the first season of Dance Academy, and I went over for a big conference over there. And I just remember thinking, it's that line in the song, if you make it there, you've made it anywhere. And I just remember I was there to celebrate the fact that we'd made Dance Academy. And it just, it was really exhilarating. And I think it was that moment, and I know Sam, the writer of the film, felt the same way, that made us think, because it's so inspiring. It's such a city that makes you believe anything's possible. And that's why we wanted to go there for the film, because it's really inspiring sort of place. So, yeah, but it was first time I've been there in the summertime, and it was hot. It was really, really hot. Our first day on set in Times Square, it was about 44 degrees, really, and it was pretty full on. But it looks fantastic in the film.
Yeah.
And we were chatting earlier, and you mentioned some of the reaction of people as you were filming in New York in different locations, given New York has lots of international tourists there. Do you want to give us a little bit of an insight into some of the reactions you were getting from people as you were filming, or out in front of Times Square, or wherever it was that you were filming?
It was amazing, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah. We had crowds at one point, all sort of huddled around in this one section watching us, and then, people asking for photos and signatures and saying how much they love Dance Academy. And
people found out on Snapchat they were there, so they'd come from all over the city. And I remember this one, she would have been about 22 years old, and she was from Germany on holiday, and she saw Tara and burst into tears and sort of couldn't stop stop crying. And so Jenya, who plays Tara, had to, you know, kind of spend 5 minutes with her, getting her to calm down. I think for her it was just such a shock. She just wasn't expecting to see Tara in the middle of Times Square. But it's one of the amazing things about Dance Academy, that it's on screens. We're in 160 countries around the world, so the fact that you guys can go to any country and, you know, people recognise you. It's a nice sign that the show has, reached out there and it matters to people.
Yeah. And how does that make you feel, Jo?
Oh, I'm sort of amazed. I had one moment. We took Jenya, Alicia and Jordan, we went to Germany and Spain on a publicity tour, and there was one moment, we're in a shopping centre in Germany, and there was this massive long line up waiting to get autographs. And I just had to go away and have a little tear because I was just so proud. You know, it seemed amazing that we'd come from this, you know, little country on the other side of the world, and there were people there who were so excited because of the show.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
I imagine you take a lot of pride in that.
Absolutely, yeah.
Absolutely. Okay, our next one is, we're back to Melville Primary School. This is for you, Alicia, question 14. Who have we got at Melville asking this one?
Audrey is asking this question.
I'll just read that one out again so everyone could hear. It was a great question from Audrey. How many times do you need to look at your script to learn it and know it off by heart?
If you're out of the game for a little while, it takes a little bit longer. But because I know Kat so well, and I guess the way and the rhythm that she speaks in, it gets easier as you go along. When I first started acting, it probably took me, you know, quite a while to remember lines. But then I guess the way that I end up sort of looking at it now, it is a conversation. You're always having a conversation with somebody else, and as long as you're listening to what the other person is saying, then it becomes quite easy to sort of answer without necessarily completely and utterly knowing your lines. But
so if the script makes sense to you and you think it's a reaction that you would have as that character normally, it's easy to remember?
Absolutely, yeah. I think... If I've done an audition and there's a script where I'm auditioning to be a doctor and there's all these massive words, that's when it becomes difficult to remember. So I will probably spend, you know, an hour or two trying to learn my lines and getting them perfect. With Dance Academy, most of the time we'd get an advanced schedule, and then the day before we'd know what scenes we were going to be filming the next day for, you know, 100% certainty. So... I probably spend a good hour or two learning lines for the next day, I'd say.
Thank you to Audrey for that question, and thanks for a great answer, Alicia. This next one's for you as well, and we're still in at Melville Primary School for question 15. I think this one's from Charlie.
Charlie.
How hard was it to get an audition and then the part? Was it very competitive?
Yes.
Oh yeah. Good question. It was extremely competitive. The audition process was a really long one. It felt really long anyway. But the first audition that we did was a big dance dance audition, and there was a lot of girls in one class. So we did. We first did the dance audition, and then the second round of auditions, if we got through the dance audition, was an acting class kind of thing. We were in there and we had a scene from the script, and we I think we sort of just stood up in front of everybody and then did those lines. And then from there, I got auditions. I think the first audition that I got was for Kat, and then I got another call through, and I had the audition also for Abigail. And then I got another call through and had the audition for Tara. So I auditioned for all three girls. I came into ACTF and auditioned here.
Yeah.
I think I did all three characters in one go, in the one day. And then the last round of auditions, I was just auditioning for Kat, and we were flown up to Sydney to do a dance class up there, and then we had to do a solo as well, and then we went and we did chemistry reads with with the other characters, and then from there, I think it was, how long do you think we waited? Maybe a couple of weeks before we got...
Oh, I think it was only 1 week.
Was it one week? Yeah.
It was pretty close to filming by the time we'd made the final decision.
Yeah, so...
And how did you find out?
And I found out, so I can remember it so clearly, I was... in my friend's car, we'd gone to the shopping centre, and I remember just thinking, wouldn't it be funny if I got a phone call and we were underneath in the car park and it cut out just as, you know, they were saying that you get this role. And sure enough, my phone calls and it's my agent and I'm looking at it going, stop, stop, hold on, wait. And so I answered the call and I was like, hello? She goes, Alicia, we're... And I was like, hold on, wait, it just cut out, and then, anyway, eventually I heard it, and I was told that I had the role of Kat, and I screamed, I absolutely screamed. I remember calling Mum, and I was like, Mum! so it was quite a long process. I think, it was, and, you know, obviously very competitive, and it felt very competitive because I wanted it so badly, and there was obviously a lot of people going for it. How many people do you think auditioned worldwide? We had New Zealand as well. People auditioning in New Zealand and Australia. There was a lot of people.
And Australians who were overseas, they sent their tapes in. So we definitely wanted the cast to be Australian, but there are Australians ever around the world. So, we saw thousands of people.
But it was such a long process.
But the first time we saw you in the audition, and this was the day, I think we did 2 days in Melbourne where we would have seen about 600 people, and Alicia was there, and Sam Strauss, the co-creator, and I were sitting next to each other. And we kind of didn't have to change our mind from there. So,
yay! I think Kat was definitely the character that I really wanted as
Dina
well.
Dina really wanted that character too.
Yeah, so and Dina went for...
Yeah, Dina, who plays Abigail, we just instantly thought she was Abigail, but she thought she was Kat, and it really had to... Because Kat is more like she is in real life, you know. Dina's into hip-hop, and she's a DJ, and Abigail is this straight classical ballet girl, and Dina just kind of didn't think that was her, but we just saw that, and she was Abigail.
Absolutely, yeah. That was a good question. That was fun.
This is probably for you, Joe. If Alicia hadn't have turned up that day and become Kat, would Kat be different now without Alicia playing?
Oh, she would have to be, because whilst we had Kat written on the page, and we just saw that in Alicia so much, I've cast a number of shows now, and you're really trying to find somebody who inherently is that character. But quite often you need to just change things a little bit, or that character then evolves depending on who the actress is. So I just think that Alicia was meant to be Kat, and I can't imagine anyone else ever being Kat. But if it hadn't been somebody else, if Alicia had decided not to audition that day, we would have had a very different Kat, and we would have then evolved the character to be like that person, but it would never have been the same. Very grateful that it was Alicia.
Okay, so another question for Alicia, question 16. I think we're heading back to Dunsborough Primary School. Dunsborough not on at the moment, so I'll ask that one. I think it was Nell had this question for you, Alicia. It was, how do you remember all of your lines and dance routines?
I guess it's something that I've been doing my whole life, and so it's kind of become second nature. Obviously, practice is the main sort of thing. Like I was kind of saying before, dancing and acting at the same time is hard. And so we had a lot of, obviously in the lead up to filming, like I've said, we had the boot camp. We had a whole month of boot camp.
And boot camp is where we really made the actors work really hard.
We did.
So it was dancing, and it was...
Acting classes,
personal training. It was boxing and running it was hard.
Yeah, so there was a lot of stuff. And so also throughout then, we started learning choreography throughout that rehearsal process, and then obviously while we're filming as well, we had other classes. Whenever we weren't filming, we were sort of doing a dance class or an acting class, and working on the script in there too. So yeah, it's all got to do with practice and then putting it together and rehearsing and seeing what works and what doesn't work. And that's kind of the main part about it is the way I remember them is just practice. And like I said, with understanding what I'm saying and having a conversation with someone else as well, it becomes easier when you know the character, I guess. Yeah.
Thank you to Nell from Dunsborough Primary School for that question. We're heading back to Melville Primary School for question 17. This one's for you, Jo.
I'm going to Mark.
We've got Mark there.
Yeah,
Hi. Hi, Mark. Fire away, Mark.
What made you decide to make a movie, and why did will there be any more movies to follow up?
We decided to make the movie. We always wanted to, but we didn't really think it would be practical. We didn't know that we'd be able to. But after we started the third series, we thought, I reckon we could make a movie, and so it was amazing that we did get to do it. And we wanted to see it on the big screen. I love going to movies; it's my favourite thing to do. And the idea of being able to go and watch our movie seemed like it would be the best thing ever. So that was kind of the reason we wanted to do it. And we also wanted to see these characters again. We hadn't had enough of them. So after making 65 episodes, we had a little bit of a break, and then we thought, yeah, we want to see more of these guys.
Yeah.
So and luckily, because we didn't know if all the actors would want to come back either. Everybody was doing things, and it'd been a few years. So we were really lucky that we got, everybody said yes, which was fantastic. And if there's going to be more movies, well, I would have to say I desperately hope so. And the best chance that we have of making more movies is if everyone goes to see it. So not to sound like a spruiker, but
it's in their hands.
Yeah,
it's in their hands.
Absolutely.
But yeah, it's certainly our dream to make more. We've decided that we went to New York this time. We've got, we'll put it out there to the online community to tell us where we send the next one.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Spain, France.
Just anywhere casual like that.
Could be Melville Primary School. That could be the location.
Exactly.
Now, I think we're staying in Melville Primary School for question 18. Alicia, it's for you. Who's asking that one?
Joseph is asking this question.
How does dancing make you feel, and how do you overcome your injuries?
So I think it was, how does dancing make you feel, and how do you overcome the injuries and pain that you must experience along the way?
I guess dancing makes me feel so many different emotions. I love it. I've always loved dancing, and growing up, I always found it fun. It was always something that I loved doing, and it was, I guess, a bonus that it sort of just helped me stay fit. But on top of that too, the emotion, I guess, when you start moving your body in a certain way, it's a little bit overwhelming, and the same thing happens when I watch dancing, when I watch people perform. I get overwhelmed with this emotion, and it's really beautiful, and it's so lovely to feel that. And then on top of that, when you have pain and injuries as well, not being able to dance is so hard and so frustrating. As I was growing up, I danced a lot, and I had a lot of issues with my knees and my hips. And I had to go to physios and I guess do a lot of specific stretches and exercises to strengthen the certain areas that I had I had trouble with. And it's really hard, but I think the main part about it was you have to make sure that you're doing the right thing for your body. And I never became a ballerina because my body didn't allow me to. My turnout isn't as good as what a prima ballerina's would be. So that sort of limited me in the dancing world, but then Dance Academy sort of brought me back to ballet, and I fell in love with it all over again, which was really lucky.
We were pretty lucky with the filming of Dance Academy not to have, because injuries happen all the time in dance, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But we were pretty lucky that there weren't any major injuries.
Yeah, I don't think any of us had anything too crazy. I remember
Dina twisted her ankle when she was out one night wearing high heels.
Yeah. I think during boot camp, I remember my ankles got quite weak at one point, and I couldn't do pirouettes, and I was so sad. But yeah, again, we've got to manage it in the best way possible, and we did a lot of taping, and when we had to do film certain performances and solos that I had in season two, we just taped it all up and made sure that everything was secure and I wasn't going to be injuring myself. And we always had warm-ups and stuff before we filmed as well.
Warming up was really
important. Warming up and warming down.
And hard when we were filming, because things have to move so quickly, but we really had to make sure there was plenty of time to warm up and warm down, because otherwise injuries happen.
Yeah. But I think overall dancing is amazing, and it makes me feel really good.
It's a terrific question, so thank you. This one, I think, is for you, Joe, question 19, which is in Rose Park Primary School again in South Australia. So if we have Rose Park. Yes, we do. Would you like to ask Jo your question?
Did you see big changes in the actors of Dance Academy including the series over a number of years?
You might just repeat that one, Jane, so everyone can hear that.
No,
so it was a great question. So, Jo, did you see big changes in the actors of Dance Academy in filming over the number of years that you did with the series and then the movie?
Do you know, it's funny, because I felt like we saw each other every day. It's like I didn't notice it so much. But if you don't see anyone, if there's a big gap. But then we had a big gap between the end of filming the TV show before the movie. But I still felt like, I don't feel like anyone had changed at all. And it's funny because the likes of Eugenia, who plays Tara, when we cast her, she was 15. Yeah. And now
she's 22 or 23?
And she just seems the same to me. I know that everybody's grown up and, you know, you're kids anymore, but to me, we still call you the kids.
Oh, yeah. I remember being in the production office and filming the movie, and everyone was like, okay, so what are the kids going to do? Are they going to have the lunch? Or
and you're probably thinking, I'm a kid, I'm 24.
Yeah.
But, I have to say, I still think of you all the same. I still think, I think just because I see your faces all the time so much, because when I don't see you in person, I'm watching the show, watching editing, or your posters are on my wall, so I feel like you're always with me, and I feel like you still look
pretty similar. I've got a baby face.
But I feel really proud of the actors, how you've all evolved, because for some of you, Dance Academy was your first job. Not for you, Alicia, you'd worked quite a bit beforehand, but for somebody like Xenia, she literally came to her audition because she'd found out about the audition at her ballet school. She didn't have an agent, she'd been in a school play, but she'd never acted in anything, and then suddenly she's the lead in this massive TV show, and now she's the lead in a feature film. And I do really see the evolution of someone like Jenny from, just going to being a professional actor, and it's amazing, and I'm so proud of all of you, and I'm so proud of Jenny as well, because she's the lead in this feature, and she has had to take this huge emotional journey. It's really challenging for all of you. And I just feel so proud that I feel like we got it right with the casting way back. So that was a long time ago when we cast the series, and we had no idea that we'd go on to make 65 episodes in a feature film. I feel like we got it right. So I'm proud of us. I'm proud of the production for getting that right, and I'm so proud of the actors. And look at them, they're beautiful.
And I think the rest of the world feel like you got it right too. Yeah. So there you go. That was a great question. I think our next one, Alicia, is for you. I think we're heading back to Grace.
Yes.
Education.
Excellent.
So Grace, if you're all there, hopefully we will hear all of your questions this time. It broke out a little bit last time. What have you got for Alicia?
My question was, how do you project emotion into a dance that you don't feel a connection to? And how do you keep that emotion when you run through a dance over and over again?
Wow, okay, good question. I think when it comes to especially the dancers in Dance Academy, there was always a story behind the dance. And there's always, I guess, season three for Kat, she was doing a dance based on a person that she'd have to watch. And she had her own personal feelings about this person. And so it was an angry sort of a feeling. And I think, you know, if I put myself in Kat's shoes, it was easy to feel that emotion and connect to it. When it comes to keeping the emotion when I'm filming the dance so many times, it's just, you've got to sort of sit with it for a second and you sort of collect yourself before you start dancing anyway. Let me see if I've got all that question in there.
And I'd say the part of the question about something that you don't necessarily connect to, that's something that we discuss in pre-production, because we really needed the actors to connect to what their characters were feeling, and that's the thing with getting to know your character so well. Yeah. If there was something that you didn't connect to in the scene, you'd come and talk to us, and there'd be a reason behind that. And even if you weren't quite sure why it wasn't comfortable, it was enough for us to then go away and think and talk about it, and then we'd usually be able to come up with something we'd understand why you weren't connecting to it. Is probably because it wasn't truthful for Kat either.
Yeah.
And so that was how we were able to work through it. So I really think that by the time we got to film,
filming, you did pretty much, I don't think there were big things that you wouldn't have agreed with or that you didn't connect with.
No, and most of the time, if I also didn't understand or if I didn't connect, a lot of the time it was just one simple question that I sort of need answered, and then it would sort of all just click. And I guess, if there was also just a dance, if we were doing bar work or centre work or something within the television series, just the way that your body moves when you're dancing, like I said, when I watch it, I feel emotion. So when my body moves, it just sort of brings this energy up into me anyway. So I do connect to all types of dancing sort of regardless. I hope that answers your question.
It's a great question, Grace, so thank you so much for that one.
I love your hair too, it's beautiful.
Now, we've only got 5 minutes to go, so we'll try and squeeze in a few more questions if we can. This one was for both of you. It was from Melville Primary School again, Kalela. Would you like to ask your question for both Joe and Alicia?
Where was your favourite place to go when you were making a movie?
Well, I think it's going to be New York.
Yeah, for sure. I don't know. I mean, it's kind of everywhere. Obviously, filming on the docks and in front of the Opera House.
In the Opera House.
Yeah, I think everything, all of our locations are so beautiful and so iconically Australia as well. And then going to New York, we had all the iconic places there as well. I think everywhere that we've filmed, there's beautiful locations. And I think that's emphasised too with our DOP, Marty McGrath. He just made everything look incredible, working with our director, Jeff, and...
I have to say, my favourite, so in the movie, my favourite location was in New York, but in this TV series, I loved where we filmed, so Sydney is absolutely beautiful, and when we filmed the memorial for Sammy, it was I can't remember if it was sunrise or sunset when we actually filmed.
We filmed sunset,
but it was sunrise in the actual film, in the TV show. But that location was just beautiful. It was, it was sunset and you could... The sun was setting on the other side of the Harbour Bridge, and the water was all beautiful, and the light was sparkling off. And the actors were committing so much to that storyline, and it really felt very cathartic and emotional. So it was really emotional to watch.
It's gonna make me cry thinking about it. Oh.
And they were, they went to giving me goosebumps. Yeah. They went to dance in the water, and it was beautiful.
That episode was on yesterday. It was on TV.
And that song that just kills me. Oh. But watching that film being filmed was really special as well. So I'd say that's one of my favourite locations.
I agree. Yeah, that was beautiful.
Mm. Oh, yesterday.
It was. Yeah, they're replaying it.
I cry every time.
Yeah. Mum was watching it. She's like, Alicia, Sammy.
A question for you from me. You mentioned, Joe, that Dance Academy has been seen in 160 countries around the world. It obviously has an incredible fan base around the world, and it's resonated amongst young and old in so many countries. Why do you think it's been so popular? And sort of really, it's the fans generally love it. Why do you think it's had such a global and worldwide appeal?
I think it's because the characters are real and that you can really feel what they're feeling. So I think overall, that aspirational feeling of trying to achieve your dream, I think that's sort of a general overall thing that people can relate to. But then if you break down the storylines, like Alicia's character Kat, had a really incredible storyline where she was dealing with eating issues and just the connection you can have to that story. And some of the letters we get from around the world, I think it means different things to different people. So we have, I had an incredible letter from a girl in Norway about how it resonated so much with her and made her go back to dance after she'd gone through a very difficult time of losing a friend. And so the letters that we get from different people around the world, you know that it means different things, but I think overall it's that people can really feel these characters and can really connect to them. I feel and connect to them. I feel so moved when I watch them sometimes. And I know the actors that you do as well, you feel very connected to it.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I think that connection to the characters. I mean, that's a huge credit to the actors and a huge credit to our writing team led by Sam Strauss. I'd say that's... I'd love to hear from people what it is that makes them connect. But, yeah.
Absolutely. Unfortunately, we are almost at the end of our hour-long webinar. We've had so many wonderful questions from people throughout Northern Territory, WA, South Australia.
School of the Air, fantastic.
Thank you to everyone that sent in the School of the Air, the side students from Western Australia. So thank you so much for your terrific questions. And I apologise if we weren't able to get through all of them, but we've run out of time. Again, we'd like to encourage you, April 6th
is
the release of the Dance Academy movie. We can't wait, because I haven't seen it, so I'm looking forward to it too. I'd like to thank so much Joe and Alicia for coming in.
Thank you.
And for all the marvellous questions we've had from students throughout Australia. We hope you enjoyed it, and we look forward to seeing you next time. And get off and see the Dance Academy movie.
We hope you love it.
Yeah, thank you, everybody.
Thank you so much.
See you.
We'll see you next time. Bye.